If you have information living in Airtable in a different database, sometimes you need to access it in other databases as well. Well, for this particular use case, we need to use a synced table in Airtable. So if learning about synced tables is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. And Airtable is at the front of that. Now, before we hop into the heart of this video, I'd like to quickly invite you to join me for my automation training. If you are new to no-code tools, you really can leverage a lot of power from understanding the fundamental building blocks of automation, and I'm going to teach that to you in my training. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and it doesn't matter what no-code tool you're using, this training is going to help you understand how to start building automated processes. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video, and we've got to talk about these synced tables. Now, first and foremost, when do you need to use a synced table? Well, synced tables are great to eliminate redundant data entry. So if you have data that lives somewhere already inside of Airtable, but it's not already in a specific database, you don't want to have to enter that data again and again and again. Instead, we're going to use a synced table to grab that information from a different source and bring it into our other database, wherever we need it. So let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and I'll give you this example step by step. Now, first off, we are inside of this events context management base. And so the idea here is in this database, I've got a table for people and I have a table for events. And I link those two things together. So when I attend an event, I'm doing networking and I'm meeting new people. So I've got three example people that already started in this database when I downloaded it from the Airtable universe. So thanks to whoever put this database together, made my job a little bit easier to put this together quickly. So here you can see we've got three different people here, but I might have a different database where I'm tracking projects that I'm actually doing on behalf of my clients, and my clients probably come from networking events like this. So I actually want to connect to these people, but I don't have the two databases in the same place because my projects database is a totally separate entity that you see here. And so here I have my projects and my tasks that are associated with those projects, and I can just track how I'm progressing and doing on these different projects. But of course, these projects are done on behalf of somebody, and that's the part where we need to actually connect to the people in our network. Who are we doing these projects for? But again, this information lives in a totally different place. Now, a restriction of Airtable is that this information, any information that we want to link to in this particular database, it must exist in this base. So we have to find a way to bring it in here. But again, we don't want to just start keying in all of the names again. I could go through and connect a different table here and create all my different people, but it's redundant. I already have that information living somewhere else. So this is where a synced table comes into play. Now, in order to initiate a synced table, we have to go to the source first. And in this case, the source is going to be the people who we're working with, our networking opportunities. So I'm going to flip back into that particular database. So here I am in my events contact management, and I'm inside of my people table. And this is where I have the people information that I want to link up to those projects. So in order to first prepare a synced table, the first thing I need to do is choose a view inside of this table. So I know I'm in my people table, but is there a view in here that I want to sync up? And the reason that we might use one view over another is because we might want to restrict the information that's getting synced into the secondary source. So for example, here I have three different people here and they have three different recruiting contact types. Maybe I want to only include people in the business lead and the networking contact type and only sync those people over to my secondary source. So let's first create a view specific for that. I can come down here and create a brand new view. In this case, I'll choose a grid view and I'll call this contacts for sync. And then I'll go ahead and create this view from here. And now I want to apply some filters to this view. So I'll come up to the filter toolbar and I'll add a condition And specifically, I want to look at that contact type, as I said. So we'll scroll on down and find that. And now we'll say, is any of, and we'll select the different types that we're willing to bring in for this sync. So I don't want to look at the recruiting contacts, but I do want to include business lead and networking contacts. And you'll see as I do that, my other contact is removed from this view, and I only have the two contacts here. So now I have my contact view set up in such a way where only the information I want is being filtered in. Now it's time to create the synced view. The easiest way to do this is to come up on top where it says share view. So I'll click on share view, and this is where I'm going to tell Airtable that I want to allow this data to be shared somewhere else. So I say create a shareable grid view link. And here I get a link to that, yes, but what I really want to do is bring in that synced relationship. And so you'll notice my second toggle here says allow data in this view to be synced to other bases. So once I make that selection, we can then also get this little pop-up that says view sync activity. We'll come back to that in just a moment. But now this is allowed to be synced, and we can now sync this view to another base. My other base is called business operations. So if I push on sync this view to another base, it's going to open up a different modal for me here. And it's going to say, where do you want to share this? So choose a workspace where this other information lives. For me, it's my Gap Consulting workspace. And then choose the base. And for me, as I mentioned, it's called business operations. So if you don't see it immediately, you can start typing. This is the base I want to bring a synced version in. And now we get a couple of other questions. Do we want to create a synced table that will be kept up to date as the data in this table changes? Ideally, yes. As we add new contacts to our contacts database, we want them to show up in our secondary source. And so we would want to toggle this on. Now, the other option here is that you just copy the existing data. It creates a brand new table, and that is a table that you can then edit. So this is more like a copy-paste function for copying a table into another base. But what I really want here is a synced relationship, data that's updated in one place and reflected in another. So I keep the top toggle on, and I say create that table. So it takes just a moment, and then we will be taken right to that new place once it's completed this little sync. So there it is. It's now opening up that new base. Or the pre-existing base, but now you see that we have a third new table in this base called contacts for sync. So it's taken the name of the view that we just chose to sync, and it's named the table that. Now, a couple of options that we have here, we can automatically sync changes at regular intervals, meaning that as new changes are made inside of our source data, the contacts in our example, then they will be reflected here. So we have the choice to only sync those changes when it's requested, or as by default, automatically sync changes at a regular interval, which is not publicly stated, but I think it's around 15 or 20 minutes. Don't quote me. And then lastly, we can stop syncing changes and convert it to an unsynced table. So for now, we'll keep it just at this setting. And you also notice that we have the option to delete records if they're deleted or hidden in the source table. So generally speaking, if a record leaves the source table, that is our contacts table, then we don't want it here as well. But maybe we do. Maybe we do want to keep a history of all data, even if it's deleted at the source. So we might choose to leave the records in this table. Once you're happy with your settings, go ahead and save it up and then say sync now. And we will now have a fully synced relationship. If I close this down, you'll see that in my third table, I have the two different records that met the condition that we set up, business lead or networking, and they're now available in my business operations base. So a couple things to note about syncing. Now that it's in this base, I can now link it to other things also in this base. So I can go back to my projects, for example, and say, who is the contact here? And I can link to my new table that was just added here, my contacts for sync. And I can say, hey, let's start connecting to different people in that particular table. So here, this project might be on behalf of Amanda and this one on behalf of Olivia. But one thing to note is that that information doesn't translate all the way back to the source data. Here I am in the source data again. And of course, this is sitting off on its own in the source. And so we don't actually know that Olivia has been assigned to a project in that other base unless we're in the synced base that we're now looking at. So one other thing to note is that inside of these contacts, because this is a synced view, I can't actually change this information directly here. I must change this data at the source itself. So if I want to make a change to Olivia Samuels or Amanda Merlot, then I have to actually go into that contact base and make the change right there. So if we were to scroll on over here, you'll notice that all of these fields that we synced have that same little electric symbol at the top, and this is a sign to us that these particular fields cannot be edited because of the fact that they derive their value directly from the source data. Now, one special thing that we can add here is actually a new field that allows us to jump to that source data if we need to make updates. So we can insert a field inside of our synced tables, and this is going to allow us to create a button that's going to automatically open us up and take us directly to the source of our synced data. So I'll call this sync button and come down here and add a button field. And when I set this up, inside of my action, I tell it I want you to open the source record. And so now what I can do is, remember that the source record here is actually in that contacts database. Well, if I want to update any information for Olivia, I can update or open that source record. And this will allow me then to edit the source inside of the record itself, which will then be reflected back in my sync. So if I want to change her phone number to end in a 1, for example, boom, it's now done. If I go back now to my new database where I'm looking at the synced data, you'll notice that Olivia's phone number doesn't immediately show up per the changes we just made. And that's because we haven't yet experienced the sync. And so the sync happens, if you remember, at regular intervals. And so I can manually run this sync. I'll click up here and say, sync now, bring in the most recent data. And I'm watching that phone number to see that it's going to update to the most, there it is, the most relevant or the most up-to-date information. So it just pulled that information from the source, took a second longer than I expected, but it pulled it in and we're good to go. Now I want to point out just a couple things for your consideration moving forward. Number one is that synced data doesn't currently support two-way syncs in Airtable's native environment, but in October of 2022, Airtable announced that they will be working on this and that it's close to being released. So hopefully within a few months, we'll have a two-way sync, meaning that we can edit data in either of the different areas and both of the different places will stay up to date with the most recent edits. That's going to be a game-changing feature when it comes out, but it's not here just yet as of the time of recording. Now, another thing to point out has to do with the number of syncs you get, and this is all based on your pricing plan. So head on over to Airtable's pricing to see what the current sync limitations are for your particular tier. At the time of the filming here, the Plus plan, which is $10 per month if paid annually per user, allows for 3 sync integrations. The Pro plan, which is a step up from that, 7 sync integrations, including Jira Cloud. And of course, when you get up to the Enterprise, then it's a whole other ball game where you're allowed many, many more syncs. But you are limited to the number of syncs per the smaller plans. So do check out your particular pricing model and make sure that the number of syncs makes sense for you when you're getting all set up inside of your account. I know we covered a lot here and we went kind of fast, so please let me know if you have any additional questions and I'll try to answer them. Of course, if you haven't already subscribed, be sure that you have so that you can stay up on no-code news just like this. And I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts, we have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.